Welcome back. Don't be offended, this is all my opinion. Ain't nothing that I'm saying wrong. This is a true confession of a life learned lesson. I was sent here to share with y'all. So get in where you're fitting and go on and shine. Free your mind, now's the time. You're going to find yourselves, everything is going to be all right. You see, I'm not the average girl from the videos. My average, hey, by the price of my clothes. Hey y'all, it's coming. I'm not the average girl, I'm getting the hey Markel. Hey, what's up, y'all? Minds up, minds up, minds up. It's Transformation Tag Team Tuesday, and I'm back. This is your girl Takiyah Diamond. Right, so I had to take a little break, you know. My body was transitioning and transforming and a whole bunch of other stuff. But the great thing is I am here with you today. So make sure that you share this live, because I know that the information that I'm going to bring to you guys today is going to be very deep-rooted and eye-opening for many of you. So give me just a moment. Any reason why my screen is black? Okay. I know. It looked like it was some kind of delay. Please let me know if you guys could see me, because I personally see a black screen. So if you can see me, please comment in the box and let me know that you're able to see me. So today we are going to be talking about awakening. You know, a lot of things are changing on the planet. I'm just trying to invite some people here. And please let me know if you guys can see me. I turned on my phone so I could try to see y'all comments and all that other wonderful stuff.
See, I can kind of recall a little ways back, small trying to fall, always been black, and my hair I'm trying to call. I even
all right.
Had a dopey girl at the top and all that crap. I was trying to be appreciated.
Hello. Good morning, minds up. Hey, Javon. Javon, tell me if you could see me, because I was having an issue and I was getting a black screen. So I don't know if you guys have a black screen or not. Perfect. So let's go ahead and hop right into this. Share this live for me. We are going to be talking about now that you are awakening. You have been noticing some changes. You have been growing through some things. And things are evolving for you. You know, you're starting to see the truths about a whole lot of stuff. And you're kind of wondering, like, what the heck is going on? What's really the truth? Hey, Sean. Hey, leveling up. That's right, guys. We are leveling up for 2018. You guys make sure you come out on Saturday. We are going to be doing a speakers event where it's all about mind, body, soul. And I will be doing a feature presentation on your health is your wealth. So health is your wealth. Hey, Marcia. All right, guys. So make sure that you guys share this live with me, because you are the bomb and you know that I need you. All right. So just make sure that you do me that favor and show your girl TK some love. Right. So let's go ahead and hop right into this. I was trying to find something decent to play, but whatever. So let's rock out. Hey. Happy Transformation Tag Team Tuesday. Yes. Welcome, everyone. Welcome, welcome, welcome to Transformation Tag Team Tuesday. This is your girl, TK Diamond. I'm here. I'm live. I'm direct. And I am on fire. I am amped up. Woo! Super duper amped up because everything is changing in the world, including you. So what we're going to do is go ahead and hop right on into this educational, uplifting information that I'm going to share with you today. Because you know what? If it's one thing that I know that, you know, when you're experiencing different things that are happening in your life and you're trying to make sense of it all, you just kind of like, you feel like you're in this place of stuckness, right? But the truth is that you don't have to feel stuck. You don't have to be stuck. You have to choose to be free, and you really have to just do some things, some inner work, in order for you to release all of the densities that we really just don't need anymore. You know, there's a prior paradigm that we were bound to without our own conscious consent, okay? And so my question to you is, you know, are you having a spiritual awakening? You know, are you having a spiritual awakening? Are you beginning to wake up? And if you are beginning to wake up, you need to know that you are not alone. Okay, so what is, you know, a spiritual awakening? So spiritual awakening is really like this new way of thinking that begins to dawn on you. Things begin to kind of like change about the universe. You learn new things about the universe. You learn new things about the continuance of life. After one life ends and you go into a whole nother experience of life after this, you're learning things about religion. You're learning about human behavior. You're learning about social systems, right? And you might finally see the light for the very first time, right? And you start to depart from mass media. You start to kind of like really don't want to have anything to do with, you know, television and watching the news and listening to the radio. You know, you're very mindful. You know, you become a little pulled away from being the consumer-driven person that you were, okay? You come a little bit away from this political and economical and social illusion that we have all adopted over time. But now it is time for you to go ahead and allow the veil to be pierced, okay? It's time, like the veil is already being lifted. It's up to you whether or not you want to stick the pin in it and go ahead and pierce the veil, okay? So, you know, what is a spiritual awakening? I guess I really should be asking, what does a spiritual awakening mean to you? What does a spiritual awakening mean to you? Because you might have come to the realization that the world is not what it seems, right? And so how individuals actually come to that conclusion, it differs from person to person, okay? So what you need to know is that the earth is actually going through a dimensional or a density shift, okay? And the shift that's taking place, hey Tim, so the shift that's actually taking place is from the third dimensional reality into the fourth dimension or the fourth density or the fifth dimensional reality, okay? Where things begin to look, seem, and become a whole lot different to you, okay? So during the inhabitants of this planet, we know that at this point that it's a lot of things that are lagging behind during this evolution, right? And we understand that positive energies, they have to flow in order for humanity to be ready for the transition. So as long as humanity exists in this whole hierarchical power structure with greed, with poverty, inequality, scarcity reigning supreme, right? The fourth dimension illusion of love and unity, it cannot manifest among people if we don't pierce this veil, okay? If we don't change our energies and we don't really, really learn to master how the energy of you begins to flow. So I'll say that spiritual awakening is different for everybody. Whether they choose to adopt a religion such as Christianity, Buddhism, Hinduism, or whatever, any other type of way of thinking, such as the Kabbalah or whatever, it is their spiritual awakening. And although the schools of thought are known to be different, it still all boils down to one underlying notion that remains the same, okay? And that's all that, and that's that we all derive from one creator, right? That is love, and we also understand that love and goodness is like the top priority, and that we have to work together, right? We have to begin to work together for a better future. Now, each different way of thinking, each different level of consciousness, of density or dimension, depending on how your brain is wired and what frequency that you can actually have the capacity to tune into and maintain. The main thing is that each one raises our vibration in the mass consciousness, right? So no matter how we do it, when we change ourselves, we actually change the level of consciousness that's taking place on the planet, okay? And we begin to actually move away from negative energies such as anger, hatred, towards all of these different things, and we begin to focus a lot more on love, and we begin to focus a lot more on light, you know, and just kind of being in the presence, being present and being in the moment, right? We gotta be in the moment, right? So a spiritual awakening, it can occur kind of like a revelation, you know. Sometimes the revelation lasts a few days, or sometimes it lasts a few years, but sometimes this awakening could be so intense, okay? And so the illusion that you were born into, okay, is being removed. It's being removed like a veil. And what's happening is a series of universal facts are beginning to dawn upon you. Your eyes are beginning, you're just beginning to see the truth for what it is. And to be honest with you, religion does not even have to be a factor in this, okay? You can think of yourself as spiritual, but not religious. The continuance of life after death, which you have suspected all along, you now know that there is something else after you cross over. You know this to be true, all right? So share this live. So perhaps the key is actually realizing that crossing over is really not the end, right? Maybe that was the revelation that you received. It's simply basically casting off our beloved's overcoat, which is your body. Your body is basically just the cover, you know, it's the shell, right? And so when someone crosses over, it's not really the end, you know? It's just that their overcoat has, at the end of the day, it served its purpose, right? And now what happens is it's ready to move on into the next stage of existence, which means sometimes your vibration and your energy can no longer reside in all of the craziness that's on the planet. You know, you have to be able to have a capacity to withhold or withstand this energetic frequency that's coming on you, okay? And so a lot of people who are unaware and who are not able to actually hold this frequency, I'm noticing a lot of things, you know. Some of them are just totally giving up. Some of them are completely just being sick, like to where it's like in their mind, they've already decided that I'm ill, what difference does it make, or whatever the case might be, right? But the bottom line that I'm making with all of this is that if you are awakening, you might have always believed that there was more to life than consuming material goods, than working a 9-to-5, fitting in with social norms. Like you knew, you felt it, but there may not have been other people around you to help you identify that. So I'm here to help you identify that today. So that's what's up, okay? So the fact that you are now awakening to the fact that the human race is not just a physical body that we see before us, but it's more like you're beginning to understand that you're actually this immortal life form that travels the universe, gaining knowledge, gaining wisdom, gaining experiences as a part of its evolution, okay? And there are several symptoms. I'm not going to go through the symptoms today, but I will go through them another time so that you could be aware of the symptoms if this is you're just discovering your awakening. But for those people who are are discovering it, I want to be able to show you what to do next, because it could be a little challenging when you're the one that's awakening and then the people around you are just slow rolling. They just not getting it. And you just like, oh my God, right? But the thing is that, you know, once your spiritual awakening has occurred, you'll be able, you're basically being able to see past the physical illusion. And sometimes you might feel a little bit lost, you know? So what should you do, you know? And it's tough knowing that you know what you know and then continuing to function in the same way, you know? Like, you feel like, what is all of this, you know? And so that's usually the overriding problem. The trouble is, guys, is that you really have to do everything that you possibly can. If you want to raise your vibration and if you want to walk into the ascension cycle and the ascension process that is taking place right now on the planet, then you have to rise up. Okay, there's no other way around it. There's no other way around it. It is happening. Whether you are aware of it or not, it's taking place on the planet. Okay, the body, I mean, we understand that, you know, in our human experience, the body still has needs, you know, and we understand that it still has certain factors of life that has to be dealt with, right? So of course, you need water, you need food, you need shelter, you know, you have to survive, you know what I mean? So it's not like, you know, once you become awakened, you could just drop off of society and be like, oh, okay, well, I'm done with this. Although you may come to a point where you just feel like you just don't want to be a part of it, because that was something for me, to be honest with you. And I still have my moments where I feel like I don't want to be a part of the game. And I think it's probably because I'm so fully aware of the game that's being played that I really just don't want to be a part of it. You know what I'm saying? However, I understand that there's a purpose. There is a reason, you know, why I have to be here and why I have to be a part of the plan. Because guess what? If I don't do it, how are you going to learn? How are you going to know? You know what I'm saying? So, you know, I got to take responsibility, and it's all good. But at the end of the day, you can't just drop off the planet. So you got to learn how to live sufficiently. You know, you got to learn that, you know, only a small amount of the population know what to do, and they know how to survive, right? So what I want to do is I want to give you guys some things that you can begin to do next now that you are awakening, okay? And as I was stating before I go into that, it's like, you know, when you're coexisting with unawakened people, it could be very difficult, okay? It could be very challenging, especially if you work a 9-to-5 job and you're around all these people who are still asleep. It's hard, you know, it's very challenging because you're trying to keep your energy up. And guys, I can't share with you enough how it's really an internal job. Like, you have to just practice staying tuned in, all right? So, and also too, let me say this, right? As you begin to awaken, you might start feeling like you want to spread the word, like you want to tell other people because you want them to awaken. But let me tell you something, guys. You need not try. You need not try. You know why? Because if it's within a person's life plan to awaken, they're going to receive a signal. They're going to receive a signal from their higher self, their spirit guides, God, Holy Spirit, or whatever guiding entity that will come through and release this information to them and allow them to begin to walk into the next level of their existence on the planet. All right? However, you may be the catalyst that actually delivers the message, like I'm doing right now, planting the seed, right? See, putting that seed of thought in there, right? But at the same token, don't preach about all of the wonders of the universal consciousness, because their view of you might change. If they're not aware of what it is that you're talking about, you could totally lose them. You know what I'm saying? And so, you know, it's do you teach what you need to teach. Share what you need to share, and those people who are ready to receive what you have to share will be drawn to you, all right? So I just wanted to share that, all right? So instead, what you can do in place of that is maybe mention a few things that you learned along the path, you know what I'm saying? And that might be enough to motivate the other person to cross on over or to start digging a little bit. You know, and I tell people all the time, don't believe whatever I say. Go find out who you are for yourself. Allow what I share with you to be the plug, but you know what? You have the power. You know what I mean? I might be the socket, but you have the power. Okay, so you got to be the person to plug in. All right? All right. So let's go ahead and talk about the actions that you can take as you are awakening now. What do you do next? Okay? So the first thing that you do is, what you can do as you're awakening is help others, okay? Help others. Showing love and kindness will collectively raise the vibration on the planet, okay? So I want to say this to you, right? Like a virus, when you change your behavior, it can actually become the standard of behavior, and it can actually counteract negativity, right? So if you are shifting your energy and you are changing who you are, and you are around people who have like all of this negative stuff going on, you being you can completely alter the environment, okay? So be okay with helping others. One thing you guys have to know is that this ascension process is unity. Like, we have to do this together. I can't change it by myself. I don't have the power to change everything by myself. Martin Luther King didn't have the power to change everything by himself. Gandhi didn't have the power to change everything. You understand what I'm saying? They may have had the wisdom to be able to deliver the wisdom. However, it's you as the being. It's you as this entity that has to, you know, do what you got to do. And so it's important for us to actually work together, okay? And we are all one. And the quicker you get that in your head, the better off we're going to be, right? And because we are all from the same source, we need each other, okay? The next thing is to be tolerant, and I know this part could be really challenging, right? But you gotta be a little tolerant and kind to people who are unawakened, okay? You gotta respect that where they are on their path, you know? And just because you know a lot doesn't mean everybody else knows everything that you know. So you can't just assume, you know, just going up to somebody and trying to have an awakened conversation with them, and they're looking like, this dude is nuts, or this girl is nuts, right? But, you know, the good thing about it is that a whole lot more people are waking up on a daily basis. So you're going to begin to recognize that there are a lot more people who are like you. And you start to surround yourself with people who are also on the rise, okay? People who are raising their vibration, all right? I want to be real with you on this. Not everybody wishes to awaken, okay, from this life that's driven by consumerism, from this life of constant wants, constant needs, all right? You might find that some people's behavior is unfathomable, right? And now that you see the world differently, I know this was a part of my experience. It was like, you know, now that I began to see things differently, I'm witnessing and I'm being the observer of all of the different things that's taking place on the planet and the different things that people are experiencing. And I'm like, oh my God, this is toxic, right? But at the end of the day, you know what? It's really about just kind of stepping in and allowing yourself to be the vibration so that somehow you can influence the balancing or the harmonization of it. Okay, so please remember, you cannot change everybody, right? And you can't change every wrongdoing that you see. You can't. You just don't have the power to change everything, all right? So some things you're going to have to learn to be tolerable about, because everybody has to get it at their own time. And you also have to know that not everybody is at a higher level of consciousness that you are. Not everybody's going to understand what you're talking about just yet. So be okay with the fact that they might need a little more time. Okay. The next thing is no blame, no blame, no blame. All right. Know that those who are less fortunate than you, they might behave negatively, right? But they behave negatively due to their circumstances, right? Due to their physical reality, due to their physical experience that they're experiencing in this moment. For example, let's just say there's a shooting in your area, right? The first thing that we do is we buy into the news when they start putting it on the news. And then we're like, oh my God, this is terrible. And it's not to say that the situation isn't a terrible situation or that it's not an unfortunate situation that took place. However, if we join in with the frantic the frantic stuff. Remember, this is a collective job. So on the collective, if we're all vibrating at this level of fear, and we're all vibrating at this level of anger, and we're all vibrating at this level, all we do is we keep the game going. The whole purpose of you coming into the awakening is to open up your eyes. Those blind days are over. If your behind is continuing to be blind right now and choosing not to awaken and not to pay attention to the signs that are showing up, that's all on you. It's not going to be anybody else's responsibility for you to raise your awareness and change your level of consciousness except you, okay? So if you happen to be a witness, or you happen to hear about a shooting or whatever, try not to think that, oh my God, that person is evil, right? But instead, what we can do, because we are awakening and we understand that that shooting is one of the things that we're trying to change on the planet. So we can't buy into the problem and still try to fix it. We gotta understand, like, you know, what happened in this person's life that made them be so intensely negative, or what happened in this person's world that would cause them to perform such a disgusting act and hurt somebody, right? So in the context of daily life, guys, when you encounter a negatively oriented person, for example, maybe a rude person in the store, you gotta react to them calmly. And you have to be kind, because at the end of the day, you can't allow other people to shift you. You know, you understand what I'm saying? I'm not saying don't speak your mind, don't speak your peace. If somebody is being rude and disrespectful to you, you can kindly approach them. You don't have to be like, oh, you taking too long to make my order. I ordered water 10 minutes ago. You can kindly say, listen, I've been sitting here for the past 15 minutes. And I asked for a glass of water. I know that you guys are busy, but you know, my throat is really dry and I really need my glass of water. You know, how fast can you get that to me? Okay, so it's really all about your approach, and sometimes you gotta think before you speak. But most of us, what? We speak first and then we think back after, like, oh, I shouldn't have said that, right? And so we gotta get past that. Hi, Angelo. Hey, Kenneth. Hey, Queen Mother. I love you, Divine. Yes, tolerance and kindness is evident of a truly awakened person, and it means that you have truly grown. That is what Queen Mother Imaku, who is the reason behind the Transformation Tag Team, by the way, that was her comment. I got a chance to look through the comments a little bit before my phone died, okay? So you gotta understand, guys, that a negative person, they might behave differently next time to other people just because you were different, okay? So the next thing would be to continue life with changes. Continue life, because you can't escape it. It's here. You can't escape it. It's no runaway train from reality, okay? There is a shift in consciousness that will change your reality, but there is no runaway from reality, okay? And even suicide is still not getting away from reality, because you know what ends up happening? If you don't really understand spirituality, you don't really understand the path of crossing over and going into the next level, your behind will reincarnate and come back and do this all over again. And that will be on an unconscious level as well, which is a whole nother life. I ain't gonna take y'all there. I'm taking y'all from the beginning stages, all right? So go about your daily life as before, but with changes, okay? So you gotta understand, guys, you are trapped in a system of economics, consumerism, materialism, narcissism, okay? We ain't gonna get there. We know, all right, anyway, I'm gonna let that go. However, there is a lot of beauty to life, okay? However, there are other people like me and other members of the Transformation Tag Team who have, we're on the other side. So some of the things that a lot of people are still experiencing, we no longer experience it. And it's because we're no longer vibrating on that frequency of where it lives. And you know what happens? And if we attract that, people who are awakened, we have the ability to step back and identify and say, okay, what was I supposed to learn from this? Why am I still experiencing this same turmoil or this same trauma? What is this about? Well, you have a living being inside of you that has all of the answers. It's just that you don't communicate with it because it's unknown to you or whatever the case may be. You're awakening, so get familiar with the many different parts of who you thought you were to begin to come up and show you who you really are, all right? Because that old stuff is leaving, all right? So start paying attention to the beauty of life, all right? There's an enormous potential, guys, for humanity to work together, to evolve, to express love, and to express light. But we have to become one with that experience, okay? So through experiencing these positive things, embracing the beauty of life, embracing the beauty of the trees, the leaves, the animals, and water. Y'all know my favorite. See, I said water. I'm so in tune with water. All of a sudden, I just got this really breath of fresh air. You know, I don't know. Somewhere or another, I think I might be a water goddess. I don't know. It's funny because I don't know how to swim, but I'm still connected to water somehow. It's all good. It's all good, right? So here's the thing, guys. You know, if you find inner peace from spiritual awakening, then make time for things that really matter. Like, you know, family, community, friends, or finding new friends who vibrate where you are, okay? Which means you're going to have to disconnect some people, or you're going to have to limit the amount of time that you spend with people. And I have people in my life now that I have had to set boundaries where I have to limit my availability, because it can become really draining. But in the same token, I actually can't blame other people, because I'm still the person that's responsible for my own inner energy. And I have to understand that just because they're not where I am, I can't control them. However, I do have control over the boundaries that of what I allow into my presence and into my energy field. Okay? So in a spiritual awakening, sometimes I gotta bring this up, because as you're going through a spiritual awakening, you may also experience a hell of a lot of turmoil. Okay, you might just get this bombardment of like everything just going wrong. Finding a new place to live, you lose your job, your husband leaves you, your wife is doing other stuff, whatever. But the one thing that you have to understand is that if it causes inner turmoil due to, you know, heightened awareness of what's really, really real now, you know, or what the next level of this unfolding and this unveiling is, then you have to understand, guys, that inner turmoil is actually coming up to be released. It's not coming up for you to just keep staring it in the face over and over and over and over and over again. It's coming up for you to ask yourself, you know, what did I learn from this experience, and what do I prefer? See, we so focused on this is what happened and that is what was done. But you also have to begin to change your language and start saying that, okay, being that that's what happened, I recognize that that's what took place and that's where I was at that time. I recognize now that, you know, my beliefs created my reality, and a lot of the beliefs that I was holding on did not belong to me. I'm understanding this now. And so now that I'm understanding this, this is my opportunity to rise above, okay? So let it come up, address it, but then just go inside and feel through the emotion. Feel through it. Okay, so when it comes up, fill it out and then just let it subside. The thing is that when it comes up, we're so quick to try to knock it down and try to address it. Oh no, I don't think like that. Oh no. And you know what? Sometimes you gotta feel through certain things. You have to, okay? It's a part of the process. It's a part of your awakening, all right? So at the end of the day, guys, you know, what you can do is if you begin to face like a lot of inner turmoil, figure out a way that you can actually, you know, use that inner turmoil to heighten your awareness on the different things that you can do to actually help with it, okay? So maybe improve the social environment that you might live in, the community that you live in, whatever it is that will bring you some kind of peace because you're actually helping out, okay? And I think the last thing is learning. keep learning, as you are awakening, as the veil is being lifted, as things are being unfolded, okay? You need to keep learning. You have to keep gaining experience, because that's how you overcome, through the experience. It's not like, oh, you go to sleep, you wake up one morning, oh, I'm awakened. No. It's now that you are beginning to awaken, you're going to have to change some behaviors. You're going to have to change some of your eating habits. You're going to have to do some different things, okay? And that's just the bottom line. You can't get through that. I mean, you can't get around that, okay? So I recommend reading, you know, reading a lot of books. Or my favorite is, I'm more of an audio person, is maybe watching personal development YouTube videos, watching videos about awakening. What does it mean to even awaken? Do you even understand that? You know, so it's like I share with you the basics of it, but go further. You know what I'm saying? Don't stop with me bringing this to your awareness. My bringing this to your awareness is for you to up level. Okay, that's the whole intention of it. This is for you to, for me to spark some neurons in your brain, for you to start recognizing that I gotta do something different, okay? Because now I recognize where I am, I'm starting to recognize how I got here, but even more, you're beginning to recognize that you can alter it. It's just completely up to you. And you have to understand, guys, that knowledge will actually, well, I'm going to say applied knowledge, because you can know a whole lot, but you take no action towards that. And so it'll just be stored knowledge. So applied knowledge will actually facilitate your continued spiritual progression. Okay. And you can make some good friends, some brand new friends, who are on the same path as you, who will help you evolve into your next level of existence, okay? And you'll meet some really wonderful acquaintances along the way. You'll probably find a whole bunch of new opportunities start to show up to you or for you, because what? Now you're vibrating in a different direction, all right? And so I close out this live today by saying, guys, that you have to remember that the underlying notions of the spiritual awakening are that of love and that of light, that of free will, that of oneness of all living things, even the cockroaches. All right? And so the continuance of life and the world that we see, it's basically an illusion for our learning and discovery, okay? Why we chose to come here and go through this, I don't know. I'm still getting past that. However, it is what it is, okay? You signed up for it. Join the crowd, okay? So join the rest of us who are choosing to raise the vibration on the planet, who are choosing to be a part of the ascension, the awakening, and just really up-leveling your consciousness and becoming a better person, starting from the inside out, okay? We're here, guys, to raise the mass vibration, okay? The mass vibration on the planet, the mass vibration within ourselves, the mass vibration of humanity. That's the word I was trying to remember, okay? And so there's so many different ways for you to discover that, okay? And your revelation, it's all going to be happening on its own, you know, and you don't really have to attempt to drastically alter things, because they're going to begin to alter themselves as long as you continue to raise your vibration, heighten your awareness, and do what it is that you got to do so that you can break free from the spell, okay? So that's it, guys. Happy Transformation Tag Team Tuesday. I want to leave you with Miss Lauren Hill, who has this wonderful record saying, I get out, right? And you know what? That's what it's all about. At this particular point, guys, you really got to choose to get out. It's totally up to you, okay, what you do, all right? So choose to get out, choose to be free, choose to ascend, and keep your minds up, y'all. Keep it positive, powerful, and purposeful. Shout out to Queen Mother E. My Cool. I love you, Queen Mother. Shout out to everybody who tuned into this live. You don't know who needs this information, so please share it. Help me enlighten others. Many, many, many blessings to you guys. Love and light. Jesus.
Speaking resolution, it's no some type of solution, preventing me from freedom, maintaining your pollution. I won't support your lie no more.
I won't be a child no more. If I don't have to support the lie anymore, guys. You don't have to live in this struggle mindset. We no longer have to live under this illusion. We no longer have to live under the veil. We have to choose to pierce it. Pierce the veil. Because you don't have to live under the illusion anymore. All right? Mind's up. Deuces. Namaste.
You thought I'd stay here hurting. Your guilt trip's just not working. Repressing me to death.